This is our Stein's at Home Easter box, and we start with steamed scallops with spring onions, ginger, soy and coriander. For a main course, we've got grilled fillet of sea bass with vanilla vinaigrette, asparagus and new potatoes, and finally for the dessert, we've got a lovely classic lemon tart with Cornish clotted cream. So first of all, a makeshift steamer. I've got a big pan like this. So in the bottom of this pan, I'm gonna put about 2 centimeters of water and then put the scallops on top. There we go. Now then, on top of that, I'm gonna put some chopped ginger. So here's the ginger. Try and finely chop the ginger because you don't want too large pieces of ginger. It just, it's a bit hot. Love chopping ginger because you get this lovely lemony, gingery smell as you chop. I think the thing that separates Chinese and Japanese cooking, and probably Southeast Asian from other seafood cookery, is just the use of ginger with fish or shellfish. It works a real treat. Don't need too much. So what I'm doing is just starting the cooking process, just waiting for that to get the steam going. Right, lid on. We're going to steam those for about 3 to 4 minutes. And while I'm letting those steam, just got my spring onions here. Just going to chop those very finely. Right, that's ready to go. And now the coriander. Just going to take some of the stalks off the coriander, not a lot. Just chop the coriander. Now I think we've got 3 minutes gone by on the scallops, so just check those. Yes, they're coming on really well. You can see they're beginning to, what was, I would say, translucent, has now become opaque. So another minute should do that. And the whole point with steaming scallops is you don't want to overcook them, because actually you can eat scallops raw. They're absolutely delicious. If you like sashimi, you know, that's a Japanese raw fish, a sliced scallop is one of the elements in sashimi, is fabulous. I'd say we've got about 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Yes, lovely. So now all I need to do is add the spring onions like that. What's nice about this is some of the steam water has gone into the shells, which will be actually very nice. So before I put the coriander on, I'm now just going to add the soy to each one. Oh, lovely smell, honestly. So there goes the coriander. Yum! There you have it. Steamed scallops with spring onions, soy, ginger, and coriander. So the main course now for the Stein's at Home Easter box. So let's start with the bass. And I've got 2 lovely fillets of bass here. I'm just going to paint them, anoint them with oil, and season both sides with a little bit of salt and black pepper. And then in the oven, hot grill, and put them really high up in the grill so they do catch the radiant heat from the grill bars. Okay, now quickly moving on, I've got here a little pan for the dressing, and this is a vanilla vinaigrette, and basically it's a vinaigrette made with vinegar, clarified butter rather than oil, and vanilla, just a tiny touch, which is very satisfying. So here's the vanilla vinaigrette. Now I'm just going to warm that through. I don't want to boil it, and we just let that come up very gently. While I do that, I've got some water just simmering away here, and add my asparagus. Right time of year for asparagus. These are very, very tender young asparagus stems. We've already taken the woody bit off the bottom, so you can boil the whole asparagus. And that needs to go into a boil for about 3 to 4 minutes. So we'll just leave that to do its thing quietly. Just check my dressing now, which is coming up very nicely. And now the additional ingredients to the dressing is some chervil. I'm very fond of chervil. I wish we could get it more easily in supermarkets or anywhere really. It's a perfect herb of fish. Add that and the tomato. And that's the dressing ready to go. Just take that off now. Okay, time for the bass. Out that comes. Brilliant. I just love cooking fish like this because it's taken up a bit of colour, not a lot. 2 fillets of bass. Lovely fish. very nice cook this way. So all I need to do now is just spoon the dressing all around the bass fillets. Easy to do this one, by the way. And now my asparagus as a little side consideration. And finally, I've got some potatoes. You can either warm them in the microwave for about 2 minutes or just put them in some gently simmering water for about 10 minutes. And there we have it. Grilled sea bass with a vanilla vinaigrette, asparagus, and new potatoes. And to finish, well, what could be nicer than a simple lemon tart? Well, a little bit nicer would be a simple lemon tart with Cornish clotted cream. So, there's the lemon tart, and then I'm just going to make a little lozenge of Cornish clotted cream to go with it. There we go. Don't want to overdo the clotted cream. It's very, very lovely, but very, very rich and delicious. So for the Steins at Home Easter box, that was steamed scallops with ginger, spring onions, soy and coriander, grilled fillet of sea bass with vanilla vinaigrette, asparagus and new potatoes, and finally, classic lemon tart with Cornish clotted cream. Order your box now at rickstein.com.